So I understood you went through some surgery issues and some injury issues at some point recently. Is that correct?
Yes, last September, 7 months ago, was when I had my second shoulder surgery. So far, so good.
So I think it says something that you can call on the background that you have in your career, a stellar international career it is, to be able to have a second shoulder surgery and find a way to retune and refocus and reboot and get yourself back to the speed pretty quickly. How has it been in terms of what you expected versus the reality of the post-surgery crisis?
Well, I think everything comes down to how bad you want and how bad your dream, I mean, how much your dream needs to be. And if I had to go through surgery, if I had to go through pain and disappointment through the recovery process, I mean, nothing of that is bigger than my dream, than my inspiration for swimming.
So speaking of dreams, you got something coming up here across the next few months as you dialed up for 2020 in Tokyo, I imagine. Talk to us about where you're at and your plans for that meet and the goal of qualifying and so on.
Yeah, I couldn't even think about Tokyo yet. We have world champs this year and Americans. Next year we're still going to have trials, national trials for the game, so we're trying to make a step at a time. As we talked, we just went through a surgery recovery, so taking a step at a time, make sure I can race, be healthy and be competitive every day to go.
Ladies and gentlemen, he has the fastest time in the world this year, he's your champion tonight. Ringo Curtis out of Coral Springs and Brazil, winning $4,000.
It's amazing to hear a meet with you. You're calling it.
Ringo Curtis, ladies and gentlemen, there he is, your champion. Wrapping up our festivities tonight as he picks up a check.
Thank you.
Of $4,000. And as we wrap up our time with you tonight, we want to say thank you once again for coming out to the campus of the University of Louisville.